Each team and organization has unique needs for change management, so having a system that can fit lots of needs is the first step toward governance that doesn't get in the way. Hi, Matt Barron, Product Specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Service Desk, you can build a custom change workflow to fit your needs or any frameworks or best practices or regulations you need to conform with. Before we get started, you can always grab a trial instance of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along. For most teams, building a normal change request is the biggest challenge, so we'll go through just that. Just keep in mind that for standard changes, you'll likely build a unique request and workflow for each type of change so that you can later automate it and integrate it with the systems that actually perform the changes. And for emergency changes, you will likely just need a separate form with slightly different workflow, maybe no approvals, but it's meant basically for documenting the changes after the fact. Hopefully this video gives you a feel for all the customization and configuration you can do for change. But if you have any questions or issues, please feel free to reach out, add a comment below. We would love to hear more from change managers about what we can do to make your lives easier. For normal changes, it's pretty common to have a form called the Request for Change. And this will include the details needed to inform others and give the context needed to successfully change. So, we're going to create a request for change workflow to start, and that workflow will start with data collection. Here, I've created a form with a list field for the type of change, so people can choose standard, normal, or emergency changes. If I've got other changes that I want to list here, I can just hit this plus sign and it'll add another item to this list view. Also, a rich text field for a simple description of the change. And then down here, we've got a reference field for the configuration item. This will be the primary configuration item that is changing for this specific request. This could also be a whole service. So if you're taking down the business intelligence service or the communications service, this could be a higher level CI. Or it could be an individual item like a server or a network device. Next, we'll ask for a change date and time by having just a date and time field here, specifically when is this change going to occur. And of course, we'll add some rich text fields here for change plan, backup plan, simple risk assessment, any documents you need to attach. There are lots of options. Now I should stop here and mention, this form could contain anything you want. You could have it reference the people in your organization, and maybe you have to select specific people who need to review the change. Or it could also reference the locations of your business, and those are the locations that are impacted. Whatever you need, it can be added here and referenced throughout the change. Okay. Now that we have the form all built up, we need to do something with this information. So, for our situation, we send this change to the manager of the person who submitted the form. If I go into this node, you can see I've specifically listed the customer's manager as the approval type. Now, you might have more complexity or additional needs. And of course, our system can accommodate complexity. For instance, some teams are required to change to approve all changes through a change advisory board or a security team or an architecture review. And these are all possible with Service Desk. You can actually put that specific here, first response from users that belong to a group, and then choose, say, the cab group, or maybe it's the ECAB that needs to review it. You could choose instead of first response, maybe you need a fixed percentage, like over half of them need to approve it. So then you put 51 here, and then the members could be, you know, the CAB or the ARB if you have an architecture review board, whatever you need. This system can accommodate for what you need. I'm just gonna save. Now, while we're on approvals, it's important to note that Service Desk has approval delegation as well. and expiration, along with many, many other options to build the options that your teams require to make this a good experience. You know, if this manager is out of the office, let's make sure that they can actually delegate their approvals to someone so that business doesn't stop once we go on vacation. Now, once we get past the approval section, we can do a quick API integration to add this change to an Outlook calendar. Here you can see we've got a simple post and it's going to provide the details of the change in that specific calendar entry. And that's super handy for people to know the forward schedule of changes and what's going on that day. Which brings us to implementation day. On the day the change is occurring, you have a lot of options on how to handle work. Maybe you're highly controlled. Maybe you have specific tasks identified that need to be documented and completed. For this, you can put in predefined tasks in your workflow, including individual phases of the changes, or maybe you're a little less structured and you can leave this off. If you do leave this off, application teams can perform the work at their own pace and in their own way. They can even add ad hoc tasks and build the structure of the change in the moment. They can do it right before, they could do it after. Plenty of options for all types of teams and companies. Here you can see down below, further in the workflow, not only do we have change rejections and change cancellations, but we also have after implementation a review state, which is going to send off a specific task to provide the result of the change, whether it needed to be rolled back, and then some specific details. And it has a decision tree for whether we need to roll it back. If there is a rollback, then we're putting out some specific tasks to do that. So set the previous server as primary, for example. That's just one specific example. And then here you can see we reach the end. And here we can see the result. This is my change form that I've designed. It's as if I'm coming in here as someone making a specific change. I can select the priority of the change as well as the type of change. Give a description, highlight the configuration items. So here's where I'm typing in something like business intelligence, one of our specific CMDB service entries. I enter in a date and time, it's next week, along with the activities that I'm going to do, a rollback plan, and any documents that I need to attach. I start the request and I'm on my way. I can see that it's already waiting for approval, specifically of my manager. And as soon as I get that done, I'm ready to implement on the day of. This is just one portion of InvGate Service Desk that's designed to make governance right-sized for your team's needs. For more on this topic, check us out on YouTube or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope to see you again soon.